Hello everyone, welcome to Copahost. We offer web hosting plan for every type of cPanel. You can check our plans as listed below. Today, in this tutorial, we will be learning how to install WordPress with your cPanel. So for that, you need to enter the URL to your cPanel. So in your cPanel login, you need to enter the username and password. So I just enter the username. Now enter the password. I have all the details saved in my sticky note. So for assurance that I don't miss out on anything, you can keep that for further assistance. Once you're logged into your cPanel dashboard, you see you have an option under files, file manager. So click this. In the option public_html, you will be installing your WordPress folder. So by logging to your WordPress website, you have this download version, click this. You have a zip file here, so if you click this, you have the file downloaded. I have already the file downloaded, so what I will do, by right clicking this, I will be into this folder. So now you can press upload. You can select the file from here. This is the file that I just downloaded. You can see the downloading is in progress. Once it is 100% complete, you have the file completely installed in this. So now press go back. You can see the file installed here. So right click this folder and extract the details here. This is your root folder. You need to keep an account of this. So extract file. Just press close and now open this folder, select all and right click and move this to your root folder. So move the files. Now go one level up. You can now delete your WordPress folder by right clicking. Similarly, you can delete the zip folder by right clicking. So now once you have all the details in your root folder, you can go back to your cPanel and then create a database. Under the section database, you just click MySQL database. There you need to create the username. So by entering the details, you can set the username. So press create database and this will be added. You can see the message here. Now press go back. Now enter the username. So now enter your password. Once you enter, you have this strength option. If you see, you have the password generator option also here. Click this. You can use this system generated password for your user. Also, you can set an advanced permissions by clicking here. If you want to set alpha characters, you can use lowercase, uppercase, or leave them like for both. Similarly for non-alpha characters. So if you want to use this, you can simply press use password or press cancel. So I just want to use my own password, so I press cancel and create the user. So you can see the user has been added to the database. Now press go back. This was your database that we added and this is your user that we added. So now these are the details that you can keep an account within your sticky note like I have done, because these will be used to in your WordPress login. So click add and you can set the privileges to your user. See, you can copy easily from here. So check this box and you set all the privileges by clicking make changes. You just requested for privileges. Now press go back. So now go back to your cPanel. Now enter the URL for your WordPress login admin. Once you enter here, you can select the language like English and continue. Press let's go. Enter the details like database name that I just said. You can copy directly from here. You can copy the username, password as you remember. So you can leave the database host and table prefix as it is and press submit. So now you can run the install here. So this will help your WordPress to communicate with your database. Now you can set the site title, like I say my site 1234. You can set the username my site. Now this is the password that you can set, admin 1234, and you can use this if for you want to have a confirmation for the weak password. Then use the email. And install the WordPress. You can save the password if you want, or you can click never. So if you want, you can save this username. So this will be helping you in case for further, like you forget. So just log in. So this username will be used to log in. Yeah, you can see the name that we set for the site is displayed here. So now enter the username here. You can use the password that we just used, like admin 1234, and press login. This will take you to your WordPress dashboard. This is your dashboard. You can set never, where you can set your appearance, plugin, further user permission. I hope the video was helpful. Thanks for watching the tutorial.